A lot of great musicians come out of church because, well, for a few reasons, I think. One, you have to keep your eyes and ears open at all times. You have to. There's no way you could be up there ministering and not know what all is going on. You have to be able to listen to whoever, you know, if someone is saying an announcement, should you be playing at that time? Should you not be playing? You know, this is for, you know, organ players or whatever, you know, the case may be. But it just, your musicianship level has to be already tipped, like at the tip of the mountain, to just, you know, just play through a service. Because anything can happen at a drop of a dime. The flow, you got to be able to flow in the service, like whatever the Spirit is doing, and you need to be open to that. So you have to be paying attention. You have to, you know, it's an anointing too that you have to have. Most people don't understand what that is. That didn't grow up in church, but it's definitely a gift. It's a gift for sure, and I don't think it can be taught, which is something else I don't think people want to hear. But I don't think it can be taught, not in the way that you just are, that you naturally have it from just being there ever since you were a little kid. Because you know, you've been exposed to this, you just see how it's supposed to be from an early age. And so I think a lot of great musicians end up coming out of there because, like I said, you have to pay attention, and because you have to learn how to play with other musicians. It's not like you just by yourself. You have to support the choir. You have to support the lead singer. You have to support the drummer. You have to support the guitar player, organ, piano. If you got percussion, if you got horns, that's your choice. Whatever it is, or even if it's just a lady playing tambourine. If you playing the bass, you're not just by yourself. So right then you got to learn how to use dynamics. You can't be playing too loud, because you can't be louder than the choir, you can't be louder than the drummer, you know what I mean? You have to be able to keep the glue there for everyone else so that everyone is pushing through, everyone is sounding good. And so you turn around and turn that into a professional situation. You already know about rehearsals because you're going to be in choirs all day, you know, so it's not like you're going to complain about being in a professional rehearsal where you're getting paid, you know, some serious money. You're not going to be complaining about it because you already went through the church when you weren't getting paid, you know what I mean, and when you was a little kid, or you weren't getting paid life-changing money, you know what I mean, playing at church. So it's a lot because it's on-the-job training. You know, it's free, and you were made, you were told to go. You have to be here, and so all of those things, and then the love too, because the people, you know, it's love, and you playing that music, and this God is using you to help minister to His people, and when it you translate it to a professional environment, you know how to handle yourself, you know how powerful music really is. So it's like you have the sensitivity of it. It's a lot of different things. I'm not saying too much, but yeah, I think just church is just the best place because you're gonna experience so many different things that you would on a professional paying situation. So it just makes you prepared. I think why God's a lot of us church boys, you know, growing up, why we get called for a lot of secular gigs, pop gigs, whatever the case may be, it's because of the feel. It's the feel, like, besides anything else. It might not even be the attitude, because everybody's attitude is not even the best, even though it should be. You should have a good attitude, but you can get that initial call just from feel alone, because it's unmatched. It's unmatched because you're gonna learn. You playing fusion. You playing. You playing R&B. You playing blues. You play all of these different things in church. You know, you play in so many different genres that you can just flip it. You can play jazz. You can play classical. You can play rock. You can play whatever it is, because church, like, you end up playing so many different styles in church. Even if it's just a, you know, if your church isn't big, whatever, you still, whatever you sing in from the radio, you know, from the gospel stations, you know, it's at least when I was growing up, it was so many different styles, from like Walter Hawkins to Jumpy Key, which is like, if you learn that stuff, that's funk, and then that's like R&B, and it's jazz, and then you mess around and start learning Kim Morrell stuff or Clark Sisters stuff, then you start mixing in fusion, you know, you start learning Kirk Franklin stuff, then you start mixing in hip hop, then you start mixing in, you know, little rock, edgier stuff, you know, you start learning Israel, that's for sure rock, you know, and so right there you cover all the main genres of popular music, you know, most of them at least, you know, if you do grow up in a Christian church, you're playing CCM, you know, so it's like, you don't feel alone, you're gonna get calls, you know, so I think that's why, I really do.